When I watched The Planets, a documentary by BBC presented by Professor Brian Cox, there was one story that really captivated and inspired me. It was about how NASA honor Clyde Tombaugh, the discoverer of Pluto, by taking a portion of his ashes on a probe called the New Horizons that was going to do a flyby mission to Pluto. I remember getting goosebumps when I first heard about the story. Imagine the ashes of its discoverer traveled 4.6 billion miles to the planet that he discovered when mankind has never traveled further than the distance to the moon. It's really an inspiring story to me. So, who was Clyde Tombaugh, and how did he manage to be a part of this story? Well, as I mentioned before, Clyde Tombaugh was an American astronomer who is best known for his discovery of Pluto back in 1930. He was born in 1906 in Illinois, where he developed an early interest in astronomy and built his own telescopes to observe the night sky from his family's farm. Tombaugh's talent and dedication caught the attention of the Lowell Observatory in Flagstaff, Arizona. In 1929, the observatory hired him to assist in the search for a predicted ninth planet beyond Neptune, which was theorized to exist based on irregularities in the orbits of Uranus and Neptune. This ninth planet was known colloquially as the Planet X. Tombaugh's primary job involved systematically observing particular parts of the night sky. Using state-of-the-art telescopes from the observatory, he carefully captured photographs of these regions over multiple nights. His significant achievement in astronomy was his creation of the blink comparison technique. This method involved photographing the identical area of the sky across numerous nights using highly sensitive photographic plates. Each series of images documented the stars and other cosmic entities within that specific part of the sky at different points in time. After collecting the photographic plates, he utilized a specific tool known as a blink comparator. This equipment enabled him to quickly switch between pairs of photographic plates captured of the identical sky area on various nights. As Tombaugh carefully studied the images using the blink comparator, any objects that seemed to move against the backdrop of stationary stars would become noticeable. This movement might suggest the existence of celestial bodies not yet identified, such as planets or asteroids. The key advantage of the blink comparison method was its ability to detect the subtle motion of celestial objects over time, even amidst the vast sea of stars. It was through this painstaking process that Tombaugh identified Pluto on February 18, 1930. Clyde Tombaugh's innovative use of the blink comparison method laid the groundwork for progress in observational methods and technology. Today, telescopes featuring highly sensitive detectors and automated tracking systems help us detect and analyze fleeting events in the night sky. Following Pluto's discovery, the search for additional Kuiper Belt objects and the study of trans-Neptunian objects intensified. The blink comparison method played a crucial role in identifying and characterizing these distant icy bodies, providing insights into the formation and evolution of the outer solar system.
You mentioned the blink microscope. What does that involve?
The blink microscope is a device of seeing two plates in rapid succession of the same region of the sky, taken where the photographs are taken a few nights apart. We expected the only clue that we would have in locating a planet like this was by its motion through a slow motion through the star field, and therefore by taking two plates at an interval a few nights apart, it would show enough shift to identify it as being different from a star, and yet the shift wouldn't be nearly as fast as an asteroid or the thousands of those between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. And this was the clue that I was looking for.
It was called Planet X for a long time. How did it ever get the name Pluto?
Well, after a few months after discovery and some of the furor died down, all excitement so on, then the staff began to consider what would we name it, because we didn't want to call it Planet X forever. And for a while we couldn't agree. And finally, and considering the various names, it turned out that Pluto perhaps was the best one. If it had been named Minerva, had it not already been given to one of the asteroids? Mm-hmm. And so Pluto it was. And the Observatory proposed to the American Astronomical Society and the Royal Astronomical Society of Great Britain that the planet be named Pluto, and they accepted it unanimously. And so the name sticks.
Clyde Tombaugh unfortunately passed away in 1997, 9 years before the New Horizons spacecraft was launched in 2006. Although not directly involved with the New Horizons mission, he and his discovery of Pluto played an indirect but significant role in its inspiration and legacy. Led by the Southwest Research Institute and the Johns Hopkins University Applied Physics Laboratory, the mission aimed to provide unprecedented insights into this distant world and its surroundings. As a tribute to Tombaugh's significant role in exploring Pluto, NASA decided to include a symbolic representation of him aboard the New Horizons spacecraft. A small container holding some of Tombaugh's ashes was attached to the spacecraft, serving as a heartfelt reminder of his pioneering efforts and his contribution to expanding our understanding of the outer solar system. This gesture not only celebrated Tombaugh's legacy, but also symbolized the link between past accomplishments and the ongoing pursuit of knowledge and exploration in space. By carrying Tombaugh's ashes on its journey to Pluto and beyond, New Horizons became a vessel of homage and remembrance, honoring one of astronomy's most influential pioneers.
And to think that Clyde's ashes, you know, flew by Pluto, and, you know, he was finally visiting the place that he discovered, that was pretty cool.
The historic flyby of Pluto by New Horizons on July 14, 2015, marked a significant milestone in the exploration of the outer solar system. New Horizons delivered on its promise by capturing breathtaking images of Pluto's surface and collecting valuable scientific data. These images revealed a diverse and dynamic landscape characterized by a variety of features, including vast icy plains, towering mountain ranges, and rugged terrains etched by geological processes. The data collected by New Horizons also shed light on the composition of Pluto's surface. Spectroscopic measurements conducted by New Horizons instruments revealed the presence of various compounds, including nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide, which contribute to the unique coloration and chemistry of Pluto's surface. Furthermore, New Horizons observations provided valuable information about Pluto's atmosphere and its dynamic behavior. It detected the presence of extended regions of ionized gas, known as plasma, surrounding the planet. This plasma is believed to result from the ionization of atmospheric gases by solar ultraviolet radiation and the solar wind. The detection of plasma indicates ongoing atmospheric escape, where energetic particles escape into space, contributing to the gradual loss of volatile compounds such as nitrogen and methane over time. Clyde Tombaugh may not have lived to witness the breathtaking images of Pluto captured by New Horizons, but his legacy continues to fuel our relentless pursuit for understanding and exploration across the universe. And he will forever be remembered as the man who has traveled beyond the solar system. If you enjoy the video or learn something new, please leave a like or subscribe. It will be helpful and much appreciated. I'm Pandum, and I'll see you later in the next video.